differences in leading COVID-19 vaccine candidates. Some leading companies in the COVID-19 vaccine race do not use the same approach. One side uses the messenger RNA design, and the other applies the viral vector approach. Both are innovative ways to develop vaccines at a quicker pace while reducing the possibility of infecting a person. But which one is likely better in preventing infectious diseases? In the full live video by The Motley Fool, Healthcare and Cannabis Bureau Chief Corinne Cardina provided insights into the two approaches. Vaccine researchers at Pfizer and BioNTech, as well as Moderna, use the messenger RNA to create proteins of the coronavirus inside the body. The proteins are detected by the immune system as foreign, which triggers an immune response. mRNA contains the instructions to produce specific proteins, but the proteins alone are not infectious. Meanwhile, vaccine researchers at AstraZeneca and Johnson & Johnson applied the viral vector method. It means a virus is modified to carry the real pathogen. Both companies chose adenoviruses as vectors to introduce a gene of the coronavirus to produce an antigen, which should trigger an immune response. At this point, the two methods have a common factor: introduce a part of SARS-CoV-2 to yield protective antibodies. However, there are potential issues that may occur in these methods. In The Lancet, a recent paper cautioned the use of adenoviruses in vaccines. The paper showed a major problem in adenovirus type 5 used in HIV vaccine prototypes. Those prototypes were associated with increased HIV risk. Vaccinated participants in related trials were found with greater chances to contract HIV. No exact explanation was determined yet to explain the association. Also, not every adenovirus type might increase the risk. Another potential issue is the interference with vectors. Some people may have gained immunity to certain viruses over the years. According to Creative Biolabs, that immunity may react to the vector, like adenoviruses. The body may release neutralizing antibodies for the vector, not the gene stored within. This may result in lower vaccine efficacy. Novavax, a vaccine developer, prefers the subunit vaccine designed to introduce pieces of the coronavirus without a vector. The pieces must have antigen-like qualities to trigger an immune response. Of course, the classic inactivated virus vaccine design may still yield new COVID-19 vaccines in the future. The ones leading the race are expected to be the first-generation COVID-19 vaccines. Within a few years, more vaccines in different forms may provide better protection.